Hoodie, math, example 7, the slug. What? Mass of one slug? Here we go. The mass of one slug. All right, so mass is 1. And we know that mass is weight over the gravity. And then we're using freedom units again, feet. So, freedom units, we need to be back in pounds. So, what that means is if 1 is the W over 32, then the weight is 32. Not really going to impact us too much, but just going over that. M is still going to be 1. C just tells us 8 times the instant velocity. Okay. M, G, change in X. Change in X, 2 feet. Mg, mass is 1, gravity is 32, which is just really your W, right? Over 2, that's 16. Okay, so we have some data here at E, hoodie, math. X double prime plus 8x plus 16x. X double prime plus 8x prime plus 16x equals 8 sine 4t. So we have an instant velocity. So here in our cases, we're starting from a position of 0. Our instant velocity is also 0. Isn't that nice? That'll help us a little bit. This is an ocho. All right, this one's a little bit easier, a little bit clearer. So just here, let's do it over here in this time. R squared plus 8r plus 16. So that's going to be case number 2. Because r is negative 4. So I'm going to move this a little bit. Let's write out our x, c of t. It is going to be c1, ooh-wee, e to the negative 4t. And then again, because the r value is the same, we add a t. All right, there's our x, c of t. Now let's define our x, b of t. Xp of t is in terms of sine, so we would like it to be a cosine 4t plus b sine 4t. Since there's no sines or cosines here, we're clear to do that. So let's take some derivatives. Cosine, this should all look familiar because we do the exact same thing every time. Cosine, negative sine, negative 4 pops out, negative 4a sine 4t. Again, same thing here, 4b cosine 4t, second derivative, 16, so negative 16a cosine 4t, again turning to negative, negative 16b sine 4t. Let's plug them in to the OG. X double prime, negative 16, let me just draw a line right there, negative 16a cosine 4t. Minus 16b sine 4t. Again, if you didn't know, I'm plugging these in back into our original differential equation so we can get a model for our displacement. All right. Plugging in our times 8, x prime times 8, negative 4 times 8 is negative 32a sine 4t. 4b times 8 is positive 32. B cosine 4t. Xp of t times 16 is going to be 16a cosine 4t and 16b sine 4t. And all of this mess equals 8 sine 4t. So we're going to clean it up here at E Hoodie Math. We're going to look for some like terms. There's a 16a and a 16a. Cancel out today. Another cosine, that's the last one. So we're going to have a 32b cosine 4t. Same thing happens with the sines. 16, negative 16b, cancel out positive 16b, leaving us negative 32a sine 4t equals 8 sine 4t. We match them up. 32a with 8. 32b with not a dang thing. So b is quickly 0, And A is going to be negative 1/4 divided by negative 32. Okay, so now we can finally write a version of our function. That's modeling our displacement. C1 e to the negative 4t plus C2 t e to the negative 4t. And then plus our xp of t. Well, b goes away, so it's just the a. Negative 1/4 cosine 4t. What do we want to do with that? We want to take the derivative. So let's take the derivative. Negative 4 is going to drop out in front. Here, product rule, I've been liking this, doing it like this. So C2, derivative of t is just 1, so I get e to the negative 4t, and then plus t, and then derivative of that is negative 4, and then e to the negative 4t. And then cosine turns the sign, negative sign. So we get positive 1/4 times 4, which is just 1. Sine 4t. Alright. So, we're ready to plug some values in. Let's plug in our value. 0. C1 times 1. E to the 0 is 1. Let's move this up a ways. Alright. Plus C2. Well, that's going to be 0, gone, because I'm plugging in 0, and then cosine turns to 1. Cosine of 0 turns to 1. So C1 is going to equal 1/4. All right, let's do the next one. So plugging in 0 again, negative 4. C1, well, C1 was 1/4. That's times 1, e to the 0, plus C2. Let's see what we get here. We get a 1, and then that's 0, and then sine goes away. So I have this negative 4 times 1/4, which is negative 1. You add to their side, you get 1, and we have a C2 around. So C2 is 1. All right, we're ready to write our final answer. C1 was 1/4. 1/4 e to the negative 4t plus C2. C2 was 1, so it's just going to be t e to the negative 4t, and then minus 1/4 cosine 4t. That's our answer. Quick little video here. That one wasn't too bad. Hope you enjoyed it here at eHoodie.